keep somebody from just breaking their window and just going in there and taking their shit while they're not there?
Right.
That's, man, that's, and that's might, one of my fears.
It might be a day or two. You know, I mean, they got alarms. I guess they would find out, but still.
So it has, I haven't really seen any significant reports here. It seems that actually crime and everything seems to be.
We just started.
Pretty down. And, yeah. Right. Well, but up in San Francisco, I got a story where, because they have a different directive up in San Francisco, right? Up in San Francisco. Well, first of all, this gun store where the sheriff's, well, that was up near San Francisco as well, in Castro Valley. Mm-hmm. That's like 19 miles from Frisco. But in actual Frisco, there's a Walgreens that got looted. A couple, because their directive is that the police will not be answering
non-emergency calls. Yeah, I heard that.
So this couple smooth walked into a Walgreens with their big bags and just calmly and quietly filled the bags up and smooth walked the hell on out.
Oh, wow.
And with their faces on camera and everything, all the only thing they had was some shades. They didn't even like try to put on a corona mask. You know, they could have put on a coronavirus mask to help disguise themselves and still blend it in.
Right.
And they didn't even bother to do that.
Do that. Wow.
They also didn't even run a scam. No. They just grabbed.
They just casually walked up and down the shelves and got what they wanted. They said they got mostly medical type supplies and then just smooth walked the hell on out.
Oh, that's not reassuring.
And people was just looking like, and I guess they knew the police wasn't coming. So.
Do we ever talk about the time that my cousin took me to Ventures and she walked out with stuff?
No. We didn't talk about that. Your cousin took you to where now?
Ventures. This is a while ago.
What is that?
Ventures is a store that's closed now. They was like Target.
Okay.
Oh, my God.
It's like one of those stores, like box stores like that.
Okay.
So she didn't just walk out. We walked in the store. We talking about our grandmother. We talking about our family. We just talking. And we walking through like the kids' aisles and she's picking stuff up and putting it on her arm and blah, blah, blah. And then we just walk up to this customer service. And then she pulls a receipt out of her purse, and she puts the receipt down, and she puts that stuff down that she just grabbed from the thing, and they gave her a refund. She didn't buy that stuff. She just took a receipt back, grabbed the stuff that was on the receipt, went up to the front, got more money.
Wow.
And I was with her. We just chatting.
Yeah.
And I don't know. I don't. And I'm not catching on until we're walking out the store. I'm like,
right.
Why are you buying nothing?
Wait a minute. We just picked all that stuff up, went to... Oh, my God. And I'm accessory.
Right.
Just walking along.
Easy.
I'm all right with that because the statute of limitations, there ain't no Ventures no more. Statute of limitations. Way over. I'm not even swimming that
It wasn't one. Even you. You didn't even know what's going on.
Well, I would have been on tape for sure, being with her, definitely part of that.
Right. Yeah, so,
But they hit more than one store?
I don't know if they hit more than one. They just got the story about just that one store right now. Just
why would they let their face be shown? Because they don't think, like, they think there's no more law ever.
I know, right? I know.
It's just... Like, you know what? After the corona, they ain't even going to care no more. Yeah, they might.
Yeah, like.
And you going to go down for some cotton swabs?
Hello. And aspirin?
Well, speaking of cotton swabs and aspirin and all that, we have four household products. Regular, everyday household products that kill the coronavirus.
Awesome.
People should know this by now, but in case you don't, you've been living under a rock somewhere. And if you can find these items, most of them, except for maybe the last one, are pretty hard to find these days. But according to Consumer Reports, isopropyl alcohol, hydrogen peroxide, bleach, and regular soap and water.
That's the one I don't hear people talk about enough.
Right.
I am telling you guys, when I went to Food for Less a few weeks ago for my normal shopping trip that we talked about on the show, Dino, and I went, the man said, we have to limit water. We got to limit toilet paper. We got to limit paper towels. Right. We have to limit hand sanitizer. But we got pallets of hand soap in the back. All y'all buying up all this stuff and nobody's buying soap.
Regular soap. Mm.
And I was just, my mouth hit the floor.
People don't like to wash their hands.
My mouth hit the floor.
I don't know why people don't like to wash their hands.
With soap.
I actually like the physical act of washing my hands. Is that weird?
No, it's not weird.
It feels
soap,
good. The water.
Warm water, the temperature of the water matters. It has to be warm water, and you have to use friction. Vigorously wash your hands.
Okay.
Front
and
back.
Then sing 20 the chorus seconds. Of Purple Rain.
See, Dee, you just mentioned something that I've been for the last year, I've been pissed off about it at my job. Okay, so at my job, I'm on the first floor of a building, mm-hmm. and it's like a public restroom that's for everybody. It's for the people who work there and people who just come in. But I don't know who is doing this, but I feel like it's somebody, and it probably more than one, but some man, some ignorant ass man. Cause we have the faucets that are automatic. You just put your hand under it, right? And some of them have a fixed temperature. Mm-hmm. The one that we have has a little range, right? And it has the little lever on the side. And these little bitch ass men, right, are the hottest is like lukewarm, which is not even hot enough in my opinion.
Right.
That's the hottest, right? Even Danya, a little girl who don't like no kind of heat, wouldn't have a problem washing her hands with it on the highest setting. Why do I constantly go into the restroom and get ice cold water coming out of that thing and have to turn that goddamn thing up all the time? Wow. Several times a day, in fact.
Wow. I bet it's because they don't know. The people that's changing it don't know. And they just don't know how to use it.
Wow.
You think that's what it is?
Yes.
Do you think they turn that to try to get the water to come out?
I think they're going up and down because they don't know which direction is which. Mm. And they're not
labeled.
They're not patient enough to stick around and figure it out. Because I work in operations, and I see stuff like this all the time.
Okay, but wait, though. So that means that if they moving it to change it, they have had to put their hands under it. I'm saying, what bitch ass dude is like I said, some little girl is okay. It's barely room temperature.
But I'm just saying, if it's that, they might be trying to find hot, but if it just gets colder, they're thinking like, oh, this thing, something's wrong. And I find that all the time. People don't know how to, user error is the number one issue in my office. Like, it's people that don't know how to use a coffee machine, people don't know how to use a water machine, people don't know how to put dishes in the dishwasher.
Oh, wow.
And I'm not saying like they lazy don't know how, I mean, when they put it in the dishwasher, they lay a glass down on the side. Like that kind of stuff. People are, don't give people too much credit.
I hear you, Pip. I just don't understand.
Because how do you wash your hands like that?
If you put your hand under there, it's lukewarm, you trying to make it hotter, and it gets colder, you're going to leave it on cold? No, you're going to turn it back to as hot as it could be.
Well, to them, they probably just think it's broke. They might be thinking,
how would they think it's broke when it was warmer and it went colder? So if these are two choices.
Maybe when you leave it on hot, the water gets hotter, and then maybe when they do it, it's really hot. So they're like, "Oh
no, I work there."
Oh right, I don't know. I never use one.
I just think they don't see a difference. They just go like, "Oh, this doesn't work." So
I don't know. I want my water warm when I wash my hands, and I hate when I go places and they don't have warm water. That always bothers me.
The fact that
they even have that little lever and they don't use it for hot.
I'm constantly in a battle with my housemates because I'm always turning the water heater up. Ugh. So it could be hotter because I like when I'm specifically for the bathroom because I like to put it on the hottest setting, steaming hot, because when I shave and use a shaver, I want to run that underneath there. I run my toothbrush after I brush my teeth underneath it.
Yeah.
I want it hot, scalding hot.
Yeah.
So that something I'm going to put in my mouth again, they're going to have
bacteria
or mold, whatever it might've got on it. That since I was not there last, when somebody else used the bathroom,
absolutely,
whatever might be left over from because it's an old house, whatever the case may be,
absolutely.
So I need that setting,
that hot steam,
hot,
right?
And when you wash your hands, you do need it. But it's again, I've heard 15 to 20 seconds for washing your hands, and you know, you're supposed to sing Happy Birthday, but you can also, like, seriously, if you've seen the chorus to Purple Rain or the chorus to Manic Monday, also works.
All right,
just another Manic Monday. Wish it was Sunday, because that's my fun day. Just another Manic Monday, you done.
All right. There you go.
Oh, man. Taste the hell out of me. All right, so now it is time for our question of the week. Matt said, this show makes me steamy hot.
Everything makes Matt steamy hot.
Gotta love him.
I do love that man. He's a good egg.
Yeah, he is. Okay.
He's determined that he's going to come out of this the other end of this. I was like, my prediction is everybody in 2 weeks is going to be fatter and hairier. And he shaved yesterday. He's determined to come out of it not.
Okay. So our question of the week is, what is something that usually raises your spirits? All right. So, up first, we got Pam Brown. She said Macy's Days.
Ooh, shopping.
Shopping. Okay. Kmart said laughter.
Yeah.
Nice.
That's medicine.
Shout out to Juliana Anderson. Don't know her. She said time with others.
Sweet.
Joel Outcast says my Harley starting up.
Ooh, rum, rum.
Momo says really loud rock music.
Rock music.
I'm surprised he didn't put hoagie sandwiches on there.
I know.
Not hoagie sandwiches, but chicken hoagie sandwiches.
Yeah. Come on, get it right, Dino.
Right? My cousin Jazz said music and laughing.
Yeah.
Uncle Pastor Power says learning something useful.
He's a resourceful man.
Shout out to Wordy Girl Entertainment. Rosalind Jackson said, when I'm pissed, I listen to Sade, or Day Day as I call her. She soothes me.
Yeah, I can see that.
Right?
Yeah,
Sade
you
is
can't really
definitely
be tense listening to Sade.
Yeah, she will loosen you right the hell up.
You're going to unclench one way or the other.
Right? Ooh, she's the sweetest taboo. Okay, Rambo said, my pets.
Aw.
That's cute.
That's good.
Yeah.
Tanita says, worship music and jokes.
I get that. I'm not even religious, but worship music can get through that for me, too.
Yeah. Justina Allen said, kids, happy people, people living in truth. Mm. What the hell does that even
mean? Right,
I
was like,
people living in truth.
I think she just wants positivity, and that's what I think she did.
Okay. I'm like, how do you even know?
That's what I was asking. I swear to God, that's what I was thinking. Well, how do you know if they live
right,
in truth?
Like,
whatever.
Same thing with kids, because I want happy kids.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, every kid, you don't want to be around.
You don't want to be around the kids that cuss and break your shit.
They might actually make you worse.
Right. They stress you out. Yeah.
Don Don's always been a happy baby.
Oh,
she's a happy kid. Okay, that's why it's like so extra bad when she's sad. Mm. You know what I mean? Like it's
she's so happy
because it's so like jarring. You know, it's like you know I don't want to say it's worse, but it you know what I mean. It just
it almost seems worse.
Yeah, yeah.
When you see somebody that's with a broken spirit,
mm-hmm. Right? Yeah. So LJ said, cooking. Going for a walk, spending time with loved ones, and going to metal concerts. I have 5 of them over the next few months, and I'm wondering how many will be canceled.
Wow.
Probably all.
Of them.
Yeah,
wow.
I'm pretty sure all of them, LJ. Uncle was saying that he was happy that our Hamilton tickets are in September, but I don't even know if we'll be safe.
Right.
Well, the government says, the federal government, they're saying that they don't expect that all this will really be done till the end of the summer.
Right.
Yeah.
The governor said you can pretty much forget about the kids' school year.
Yeah.
Like they're not going back.
They're not going back.
Yeah.
And they're not going back.
And I'm like, my Janet Jackson tickets is in August. It's mid August. So I just don't know.
Wow.
And she's notorious for canceling
anyway.
Right.
Right. Yeah.
Oh my God.
Well, I can use that money back now if I'm really being honest, especially if I might lose my job.
Letitia says, my children, heart.
Aww. Yeah, you can have your children. I don't want them.
Right. And Tim Wilson, always the joker, said a shipment of Viagra.
Hold up.
Tim, what you going to do with a shipment of Viagra? You ain't got nobody to use it with.
You know, it makes a Peroni bang.
Hold up. Isn't the question something that soothes you?
Yeah.
That's the opposite of soothing.
That's definitely facts. Exciting. That's big facts. He's trying to make a Corona baby.
Yeah, everybody's talking about that.
Because it's going to happen.
Oh, yeah. It's going to probably be the biggest boom since the last boomers. Yeah.
It's like Christmas, 1,000 people pregnant right now that don't even know it.
The hospital's going to be full this Christmas.
Yeah, yeah. Chad Samuel Jr. said, when my wife returns home from work and we shut the world out. Carl says reggae or ska music.
Yeah, I love that reggae.
Okay, Carl. My buddy Carl said a big check.
Ooh.
I hear you,
right
man.
Right up the racks.
Little cousin Sindo said comedy, stand-up, movies, books, etc. Mm-hmm. All right. Charlie Floyd said black music.
Okay.
Shout out to the Jason and Mindy Show. And Mindy McVeigh-Galbraith says from the Jason and Mindy Show, Coming home to my husband and dogs after a long 10-hour day. Aww.
Definitely believe that. If you ever listen to their podcast, you can realize that that's real.
Yeah,
yeah, they are in love.